Problem 1. Show that there are at least three prime numbers p less than 200 for which p plus 2, p plus 6, p plus 8 and p plus 12 are all prime. Show also that there is only one prime number q for which q plus 2, q plus 6, q plus 8, q plus 12 and q plus 14 are all prime.
So when I first saw this problem, even though it's phrased as a first part and a second part, I thought it would be much more instructive to start looking at the second part to try and get more information about the problem, because it seems more restrictive that there's only a single prime rather than looking for three primes in some wide range. If the question had been asking about primes of the form q, q plus 1, this would have been a much easier problem. After all, one of these is clearly even and the other one is odd. Whichever way round, one of these primes is even and the only even prime is 2. So that might have seemed quite a simple example, so let's get a bit closer to the problem given. If we had q, q plus 2 and q plus 4, now this parity or divisibility by 2 trick no longer works. All it tells us is that all of these things have to be odd, but that's not very interesting. Let's move on from divisibility by 2 to now looking at divisibility by 3. So, if we're trying to think about divisibility by 3, we're only interested in the remainder when dividing by 3, so we can add and subtract multiples of 3 without changing the properties. As such, q is like q plus 0, q plus 2 is like q plus 2, and q plus 4 would have the same remainder as q just plus 1, because we can subtract that multiple of 3 without changing the problem. Now let's think about what remainders these will give on division by 3. If q leaves remainder 0 on division by 3, then q plus 2 will leave remainder 2, q plus 4 will leave remainder 1. If q leaves remainder 1 on division by 3, then adding 2 will get 3, which is the same as 0, and adding 1 will give 2. If q leaves remainder 2 on division by 3, then adding 2 we get remainder 4, which is the same as remainder 1, and adding 1 gives remainder 3, which is the same as remainder 0. Crucially, whichever value q has, there is always something that takes value 0. That is, one of these numbers leaves remainder 0 on division by 3, so one of these numbers is a multiple of 3. Now, the only prime that's a multiple of 3 is 3 itself, so one of these primes must be 3. But the only one of these that can be 3 is q, so we must have q equal to 3. Now we check that q plus 2 and q plus 4, which give us 5 and 7, are also primes. So we're done. The only prime such that q plus 2 and q plus 4 are all primes is q equals 3. So now let's try that approach with the original problem. So let's look at what remainder we get when we divide by 3. Here we have q plus 0. Here, q plus 2, so plus 2, plus 6, but 6 leaves remainder 0, plus 8, which is going to leave remainder 2, plus 12, again, remainder 0, and plus 14, that is remainder plus 2. Now, the difference here is that nothing has given us plus 1. That means we haven't solved the problem yet, because if q has remainder 2, then we are only going to get remainders of 2 plus 0 is 2 and 2 plus 2 is 1. That is, nothing will give us remainder 0, so we aren't allowed to deduce that anything is a multiple of 3. So that was divisibility by 3. Now let's look at divisibility by 5. If we look at what remainders we get when we divide by 5, we have plus 0, plus 2, 6 will leave remainder plus 1, 8 On division by 5 leaves remainder 3. 12 leaves remainder 2. And when we divide 14 by 5, we get remainder 4. Now, if we look at what we're adding, crucially, this time, we have all the possibilities. You can add 0, 1, 2, 3, or 4. So, let's look at what remainders Q can leave, and we'll see that just like before, when we had our table, there's always going to be something which will add and leave remainder 0. So, if Q is 0, remainder 0, we're done. If Q leaves remainder 1, we can add this 4 over here to make 5, which will give 0. At 2, we can add 3. 2 plus 3 will leave remainder 0. 3, add the 2. And 4, add the 1. So whatever remainder Q has, when we divide it by 5, always one of these options will have remainder 0 when divided by 5. That means that one of these primes must be divisible by 5. Again, the only prime that's divisible by 5 is 5 itself, so one of these primes must be 5. Then, the only options for which of these can be 5 are Q and Q plus 2. Q plus 6 is just too big. So, either Q equals 5 or Q plus 2 equals 5. But if Q plus 2 equals 5, then Q plus 12 equals 15, which is not prime. However, if Q equals 5, then we get 5, 7, 11, 13, 17, and 19, which are all prime. So the only Q which can work and which does work is Q equals 5. Now let's go back to the first part of the question. Now we're happily allowed to ignore the Q plus 14 as it doesn't appear. That means we've now got rid of this pesky plus 4, which means now if Q has remainder 1 on division by 5, then we're all good. Nothing has to be divisible by 5. So let's review what we know. Either Q equals 5, or we have that Q leaves remainder 2 on division by 3 and leaves remainder 1 on division by 5. Plus, we know that Q is odd because all these other terms are also prime. So, if we combine that with this fact, we actually see that Q leaves remainder 1 on division by 10. So it ends in the digit 1. Let's start searching for these Q, which are also leaving remainder 2 on division by 3. So we could have Q is 11, Q is 21. No, that definitely doesn't leave remainder 2. Neither does Q equals 31. We could have Q is 41. 51 doesn't work, and neither does 61, which leaves remainder 1, but 71 does leave remainder 2 on division by 3. Actually, because we have things on division by 3 and we're already looking on division by 10, it's actually like looking at the remainder when we divide by 30, which explains why these occur every 30. So we can jump right ahead. The next one that will work is Q is 101, and then we could look at Q is 131. So now let's start testing whether these possible values of Q actually work. So we've already found Q equals 5 works. Now we need to find another 2 from this list of possible candidates. How about Q equals 11? Then we get 13, 17, 19, and 23. Hurrah, they're all prime. Q equals 41, we see that Q plus 8 now is 49, which is divisible by 7, which we hadn't checked for, and this doesn't work. What about Q equals 71? Well, now if we look at Q plus 6, we're going to get 77, which is again divisible by 7, which we hadn't checked for, and this fails. But now looking at Q is 101, we get 101, 103, 107, 109, and 113. And these are all primes. So we're done. Our possible answers are Q equals 5, Q equals 11, Q equals 101.